And recording. So I'm finally getting back to Watain. So far I've reacted to two songs by them. The first one was The Wild Hunt, which was just an incredible, incredible atmospheric piece of music. They even had like an altar set up on the stage where the singer just like bowed before it and did like a sacrifice or something. It was such cool shit. Like, I can't say enough good things about it. Like, performative, and then just like the music was killer. Everything about it was awesome. Then the last one was Waters of Ain, which wasn't as long of a song, and it was a little bit heavier, so it was a little cooler. Got to show off some of what they can do. A little different pacing, a little faster, so like a lot of range to them so far. So the next one I'm going to do was a request by the same person who told me to do Waters of Ain. This one is Malfeitor. Think that's how you pronounce that. It's taken me a while to get back to them because I'm trying to like wait to be in a certain mood, because these are always such special songs and they always hit just the right spot for me, like the right amount of darkness. Ooh, just feels so good. This one was uploaded on 2016, but it looks like it's a lot older than that. So almost a 7-minute song. Looks like it might be from the same concert as Waters of Ain, I think, just based off the little tridents going up. I know that's not what they are called. There's a specific word for this, I think. The symbol in Satanism. I'm just going to jump right in. Go! Beginning of the concert?
So that's the end!
So I think that's the word of the day, metamorphosis. I think that's what he said. Earlier when I did the air quotes when I said Satanism, apparently this band is really into that. So I don't mean any disrespect with the air quotes. I'm just anti-religion in general. So Satanism is just another religion. So. I have my own opinions about that. As far as like the presentation of everything and the symbolism and all that, I lean towards this. Like, I very much like the iconography and everything. It's just actually just really cool. That being said, this is sounding kind of low in the mix, so it might just be like an odd kind of rip where the volume just got cut in half or something. But it's still cool. You can still make everything out. The sort of offbeat guitar rhythms that are happening like periodically, awesome. Awesome. It's got a nice, nice beat to it. They're going super fast. They're going heavy. Initial lyrics, since they're on the screen there, it looks like it's talking about a baby being born with the umbilical cord around its neck, causing a miscarriage. It's already going into dark stuff, especially since it looked like he started off the show, concert, song, what have you, with another kind of like sacrifice. He had his little altar there on the bottom, set it alight, up in the air, symbols behind him go up. Again, just like, excuse me, like performatively, this is like just such a cool, cool like visual. And like in a concert setting, this is just like, I'd pay money to go see this because this just looks so interesting. Let's back up a little bit, a little bit more. Metamorphosis, I think he said. Nice venue, nice and compact. Little hint of dissonance in the guitar. Nice tone. Give a quick pause there. I like how thrashy they got. Like, obviously, this is kind of like a black metal, death metal, which has certain aspects of other genres included into it. But like I said, this being the third song of theirs that I'm exposed to, it just seems like their range keeps expanding and expanding. And like musically, they're talented. Their talent keeps shining through to me. Yeah, the drummer is going off. He's doing a bunch of like crazy BPMs. His blast beats sound really cool, but I'm usually not a big fan of those extended blast beats, but it might have something to do with the mix being pretty low in my ears right now. So it's not too bad, especially since I can hear his vocals over it like pretty easily. But yeah, drummer's going off. Lead guitar is actually doing like a nice melodic kind of riff. And every time they go into the big chugs, it's just like really groovy and cool. Like, yeah, like I can't hear the bass. I can't hear the bass at all. But yeah, that's probably to do with the rip and the way the mix is coming through in my headphones right now. But it sounds like they're going into a slower, more subdued section, which is kind of what the Wild Hunt was. And I love the way they approach that style. So let's back up a little bit. Go. Cool. Oh no, it's going into an ad. Yeah, that was awesome. That was really, really cool. It doesn't seem like it has like a ton of like frenetic energy or anything to it, but it's a different kind of energy that it has. It's kind of like very condensed in like a bubble where it's like wanting to poke out. You're on the edges, the precipice of it, and you know there's some darkness or something just off the horizon, like an impending sense that you can almost taste of like doom or something. And it keeps you kind of like thrilled and on like on the edge of your seat because there's like a danger that's around you. It makes me think that seeing them live is probably how audiences felt the first time they saw Black Sabbath back in the day. And obviously this is a little darker and the lyrical content is a little heavier and darker. But back then they weren't as exposed to heavier music. And so many people would say, oh, don't you know what Black Sabbath means? Oh, it's witches and demons and devils. You can't listen to that. That's the devil's music. Meanwhile, here you actually have a satanic band. But yeah, it's you feel like you missed out on that kind of atmosphere growing up in these days where you're exposed to so many more varieties of music. And this just seems more commonplace. Like this might be on the darker edge, a little fringy, but you're like, oh yeah, yeah, I've seen people with that face paint in the memes. Yeah. I'm kind of aware a little bit. So it seems safer, even though, like I said earlier, it has that sort of like bubbling edge where like it has that sense that it could fall off the rails and get a little darker and a little bit more dangerous. And as a spectacle, this is so cool. Musically, this is so cool. Like everything about this, the presentation, even the singer, the way he was carrying himself on stage and just feeling everything, letting everything wash over him and sort of performing to the crowd, but not overly so. Like he's in his scene, he's in his mind, and he's doing what he like envisioned for himself. I don't know, it's everything about this just like checks a bunch of boxes for me. And I don't know, are they still around? Because I feel like if they're not still around, I'm going to need suggestions for bands who sound like this or who are similar to this, because I need to see a show like this. I think, what is the darkest band I've probably seen? I guess like maybe Fear Factory, but they're not really too dark. Danzig doesn't count. Gojira's, it was heavy, but I don't think I've gone to like an actual like death metal show. That's something I have to add to my list, my bands to see. I've checked off a bunch of people, but you can never see enough shows. What's the best death metal / black metal band you've ever seen live? What would you recommend as a band that you have to see before you die?